Tess.
I'm Tay.
And we're
Tess and Tay.
We are so excited for you to join us for Sunday night church.
If you click the link in our caption below, we would love to help you find your place. Whether you're still in school, you're out of school, you're married, you have kids, or you're just looking for a Bible study, we have the perfect group for you. So click that link and let us help you find your place today.
Also, make sure to join us on Wednesday nights on Instagram Live for our midweek Bible study where we're going through the book of Philippians. Thanks for joining us for Sunday Night Church. We're so glad that you are a part of it. Make sure you're following us on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube to keep up to date when we have our next one. See ya.
Jesus, you found me. In your mercy, you sought me out, lifting me out of the ashes to your unfailing love, to your unfailing love. You came for me. Lost, hopelessly lost, your life for my liberty on the cross, traded on the cross. Yeah. On the cross, yeah. King of kings, rising in glory. To the darkness, your light has come, pulling me out of the wreckage. To your unfailing love, to your unfailing love. Whoa, you came for me, yeah, when I was lost, hopelessly lost, your life for my liberty on the cross, traded on the cross. You came for me, yeah, when I was lost, hopelessly lost, your life for my liberty on the cross, traded on the cross. the blood that Jesus shed for me.
Hey, what's up, New Life Church downtown? Pastor Bronson here. Welcome to Sunday Night Church, not so live, but live where you're at from our backyard. So welcome. We got the fire going. We got the vibes out here. We've got the family. You can't see them, but I see them. We've got our team out here who's helping us. Y'all say a prayer for these people. Say a prayer of blessing for them because they're making this happen. And so, y'all, I'm excited to be with you. I got a couple of things that I've been thinking about and praying through that I'd love to just share with you. I'd love to let you in on. You know, something that's been big for me and Callie here recently is figuring out how to get in God's presence. You know, the truth is, I know you guys think, hey, Pastor Bronson, he just lives in the presence of God, like every moment, just in God's presence. But the truth is that's not something that I always nail. I get busy, I go through life, and here recently, I feel like that's something that God's been calling me too. He's been reminding me of is how important it is to be in his presence. And, you know, I was talking with the Bishop, Austin McCaskill, who I do midweek with, and it's interesting, that word presence in the Old Testament, when you go through and you translate it, it's actually talking about the face of God. It's talking about how we want to get close. We want to see the face of God. And the truth is that when you get close to somebody and you can see their face, you start to learn them and you start to learn their personality. You know, I think a lot of times when we approach the scripture, we think about God as somebody who's holy, and that's true. But Jesus came as God in flesh. He came as fully God and fully man. Go with me to John chapter 11, verse 35. John chapter 11, verse 35. I've memorized this section of scripture because I'm a pastor and I'm just really good at memorizing scripture. And so here's what it says. It says, Jesus wept. This is every Kid Life kid's favorite scripture. Why? Because they get Kid Life cash when they can memorize scriptures. And so memorize that one. That's an easy one. Jesus wept. But the context with which this happens, I think, is so interesting. Lazarus, a friend of Jesus, has died. And he's family members with Mary and Martha. And Jesus comes into the house, and Mary's distraught. Mary's upset because she's lost her family member. She's lost her brother. And here's what I think is interesting. Jesus does not come in and say, hey, God in skin has showed up. I got a plan. Quit your weeping. Let's go. Don't you trust me? He doesn't do that. He came in and he wept with somebody who was hurting. Y'all, here's what I found. So often, the things that I most dislike about myself, we'll call that our humanity. So often, those are the things that keep me from going to the presence of God. Jesus came, not because we're perfect, but because we're not perfect. The things that you most struggle with are the things that Jesus came for. Jesus does not expect you to be perfect. Can I set you free? Jesus does not expect you to ace everything in life. He knows that you're going to make mistakes. He knows that you're going to mess up. And y'all, those are the things that he wants us to bring to him. You know, for me, one of the things that I've got is I can find, we'll say the realistic viewpoint of any situation. Another way to say it is I can find the negative viewpoint if you want to be a jerk about it. Callie and I, when we were dating, I am a recovering pessimist, I would say. And so when we're dating, Callie and I was helping me with that process. And the culture that I had come out of before I came to New Life Church was a culture where we just kind of griped about stuff that bothered us and we complained. And, you know, anytime I didn't love what the pastor said, I made sure everybody knew about it. And so this is something that I was recovering from. And I remember one day, it wasn't even about church. It was just something in life that I was bothered by. I felt like I got ripped off at a fast food place or something. You know, I was afraid somebody was taking advantage of me. And before we got out of the car, Callie said, Bronson, I'm not getting out of the car with you until you name five things that you're thankful for. Y'all, I wonder in your life what you're thankful for. The truth is that we don't trend towards being hopeful. We trend towards being negative. Now, think about your life. I wonder if you have a neighbor or a coworker or a member of your life group or something like that who just drives you crazy. If you don't have that person in your life, I've got bad news. You may be that person. But the truth is, you know, we all have somebody in our life who maybe can rub us the wrong way, and maybe we could find the negative in them. You know, I wonder if maybe that person could be somebody in your family. Don't look at them, don't look at them, don't elbow them, elbows tight. But I wonder, could it be your spouse? Could it be one of your kids? Could your brother or your sister be driving you insane? Your roommate? Ooh, don't get me started on roommates, right? You know, it's easy to find things that are negative. It's easy to find things that are frustrating. Look at this in Philippians chapter 2, verse 12. Actually, let's start in verse 12b. Here's what it says. It says, not only is in my presence, but much more in my absence. Work out your own salvation. Work out your own salvation. Work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God who works in you both to will and to work for his good pleasure. Now, notice this. It says in verse 14, do all things Do all things without grumbling or complaining, that you may be blameless and innocent, children of God without blemish in the midst of a crooked and twisted generation, among whom you shine like lights in the world. Y'all, it is easy to be negative about what's happening in our world. It is easy to be frustrated with the people you live with because you're with them all the time. Y'all, it is difficult. It takes effort to be a person of hope. But the truth is I believe that's one of the things that Jesus has come to do, is he's come to help us be people who have hope, people who look forward, people who find good things in the people that they're around. And so I want to pastor you for a second, guys. There may be tension in your home. Everything may be perfect, good for you. But if I had to guess, there's probably been fights in the past couple of weeks, past couple of months. Here's what I want you to do with your roommates, with your family, with your spouse. Maybe you live by yourself. I want you to text somebody. I want you to find one thing that you love about every person in your family, every person in your home, and I want you to tell them. Here in a moment, we're going to give you about a minute and a half. If you need more time, you can hit pause on the video, but I want you guys right where you're at to take time, and I want you to exhort. I want you to speak life. I want you to tell the people around them what you love about them, but beyond that, what you see on them, what God has put on their life. Because y'all, it's easy to get frustrated. Anybody, any genius can find the flaws in the people around them. But I believe that it takes a child of God to help find the hope and the purpose in the people that they live with. So I want you to take a few moments. I want you to do that with your family. Hey guys, I love that we got to do this as a church family and in your family. And here's what I want to encourage you with, y'all. Don't make this a one and done thing. This needs to be something that I would love to see become a part of the culture of your family, where you see good things and you tell people that they do them. That's something that me and Callie try to do periodically, is sit down and talk to each other about the things that we love about each other. What I love about Callie is that she's always pointing towards the truth. She's always trying to cut through the noise and find the truth. And I appreciate that about her. So baby, I love you. Thank you for that. Hey, we're about to go into a time of worship, and y'all, I think that the reason that God loves for us to be this way is because it's good for us. Y'all, it's good for us to speak life, and so I love to worship together. It says in Psalm 100, verse 4, to enter his gates with thanksgiving and enter his courts with praise, and that's what we're about to do. Right where you're at, I want to encourage you to take some time, and let's worship Jesus.
To trust in Jesus, just to take him at his word, oh, just to rest upon his promise, just to know the saith the Lord. Jesus, Jesus. asked him how I've proved him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust him.
Hey guys, thank you for joining us for another episode, I guess this is, of Sunday Night Church. We're going to keep doing these. I don't know when the next one's coming, but it's coming. And so follow us on Facebook, on YouTube, and Instagram to stay up to date. So church, I love you, praying for you, and see you soon.